my beautiful astrology soulmates. It's me, Stormy Grace, and here's your weekly horoscope for the week of June 1st. We are 6 months into 2020, 6 months into the year. What is happening for you? What's changing? What are you learning? What are you putting down? What are you picking up? What is the exploration and experience of 2020 been like for you so far? Please share with me in the comment section down below. I love to see what you guys are getting into, see if there's ways that I can support you. And I just like to have the conversation. And you know, it's not just me asking you guys, but it's also you guys share things with me that let me remember that I'm not by myself either. 2020 has been a little bit of a trip. So I would love to hear what's going on for you as well. Put in the comment section down below. Before we jump into this weekly horoscope, this is an exciting week over here. It's an exciting month as far as June goes with the eat and greets. But we're starting out this month with master astrologer Stephen Forrest. He's an evolutionary astrologer, and he will be coming. We'll be doing a premiere video talking all about the moon. And then just on the 4th, we've got Maurice Fernandez coming over, and we'll be talking about great cycles in astrology from Venus and the Sun, Jupiter, Saturn, Jupiter, Neptune, Jupiter, Pluto. We're going to cover great cycles. And all of next week, we've got eat and greets. And the week after that, and the week after that, there is just content and beautiful astrologers who want to come and share with us and teach and talk. And I look forward to sharing every single one of them with you and continuing to learn as we go as well. So check them out on the eat and greets. They're always up on the community page, Facebook, Instagram, my webpage, wherever you follow me, you can find that information. Okay. All right, let's jump into this week. Now, as we come into the week, we're actually coming in with the moon in Libra, which is pretty nice. It's good. It's relatively balanced. We're trying to balance our internal life, make sure we've got some good equilibrium as we travel throughout the week. Very quickly on Tuesday, that moon is going to move into the energy of Scorpio. So now we start to have some depth. We start to experience depth and weight in a different place. Now, remember that in traditional astrology, the moon is considered to be in fall in the energy of Scorpio because it goes so, so, so deep that the moon actually feels a little bit out of control of the emotions, right? It's like, whoa, what is going on way down here? But nonetheless, I feel like as we come into that Scorpio moon energy, we also see the day starting to take on a place where we can't avoid the intensity of the world and the energies and our own personal things that we've got going on. So we get to stand there in the depth of Scorpio energy, not being afraid to go to hell and back, not being afraid to stand with those feelings, talk about those feelings, whatever's happening, to make the adjustments we need to really have some liberation, some empowerment, and some transformation in that energy. Now, I think things get particularly exciting once we get to Wednesday, June 3rd, because we've got the Sun, who's in Gemini, is going to merge, come into this nice hug with Venus, who's in Gemini, but Venus is still in retrograde at this point. Now, traditionally and typically when the Sun and Venus come together, this is just all the charm. It's charm, it's beauty, it's magnetism and the energy of Gemini. There's information just flowing. Now, because Venus is retrograde at this particular meetup, one of the things that I think could be happening is that maybe you're going back over conversations, Gemini energy, or you're going back over something you were teaching or you were learning, and you're establishing these relationships. You're reconnecting to relationships. You're reconnecting to that course that you were thinking about selling that one time and then you never put it out, right? Whatever it is, Venus's retrograde could be taking you to something in the past that was very mental, very conversational, very communicative. Maybe you were even networking with that energy, and the Sun is giving a big old boost of motivation and light, heat, movement, vitality to really add to that essence and kind of the pizzazz that happens on that particular day. Now, energy is building as we continue to get towards the 5th, where we're going to have this full moon lunar eclipse in the energy of Sagittarius. There will be a full moon lunar eclipse video coming. And don't worry, we're also going to have eclipse videos where Brian Coulter is coming back and we're going to talk about the solar eclipse and the lunar eclipse coming in July. But there will be a video for this one separate on the channel as well. Now, this is going to happen Friday, June 5th. Now, the thing to know about eclipses is that they tend to like to travel in pairs, right? So we're going to have one this week. And so we've got this Sagittarian one. And then in a couple weeks later, we're going to see more eclipse energy. But this is also going to be the first of two energies that we're going to have happening in Sagittarius this year. So it's like the full moon energy, the really bright, illuminating aspects of Sagittarian energy, new ideas, old ideas. Why do I think this? Why do I believe this? What do I believe? Where's my higher mind? All of this really becomes illuminated. But for this week, with this full moon lunar eclipse in Sagittarius, it's a wonderful time to be finishing things, bringing things to completion, right? What do you need to end? What do you need to wind down? Do you have an adventure? And it's so funny to say adventure because there's maybe not been a ton of traveling going on. For some of you, there definitely has been travel. There's been movement. There's been all of those things. And maybe you're bringing some of that to an end. For some of other people out there, is there a video situation? Is there a publishing, a marketing, a broadcasting, a project that you're bringing to completion, because this energy would absolutely fit under that. But I also think that this will be the energy over the next 6 months where we will bring some ideas, some beliefs to an end so that they can have a fresh start. And that may even just hit us globally as well. But in your own personal life, think about that. What is it representing to you that you're rethinking, or the light has been shed on it? And you're kind of having this emotional reset to it, because what's going to happen is with this particular full moon, right? It's going to be dark. This is going to be an emotional resetting for us. So really, where's the big belief? Where's your big ideas? Where's the resetting happening? I think it's going to be an absolutely brilliant energy. So finish up your stuff if you can. Now, I would tell you around the 5th, if you can, not make any big decisions, sign those big documents, sign those big contracts, do any of that big kind of stuff. If you can avoid it, it's sometimes really good, because with moons like this, the energy is still a bit unstable right there. You know, you have to trust your intuition and do you. But I say if you can avoid doing that, that's probably a really great idea. As we've gotten to the 2nd of June, Mercury has also begun to enter his shadow time, getting ready for retrograde. So, you know, it's just best to set yourself up for success if you can as well. Just around the day of the lunar eclipse, if you can lighten your load, lighten your schedule so that it just doesn't take so much out of you, have it be a day of rest, completing a cycle of rest or something like that. That might be really great for you as well. Now, as we get ready to wrap up this week, we come from the 5th and then we get to Saturday the 6th, and we're going to see the Sun and the Mars coming together in a square. When Sun and Mars square each other, this is always interesting, right? Because it's our light, heat, life, and vitality. That big, seamy, energetic force is whacking up against Mars, who's typically just a force to be reckoned with because he's ready to go and take on that sun energy. But Mars is sitting in the energy of Pisces right now. So he's not as super competitive as he would normally be, right? So Mars in this particular energy may not have you feeling like you just need to win the game and you need to win the day, but there will be an edge or a desire, I think, for some movement here. Mars is still Mars. So even if you've imagined something, Pisces, to be, a situation is different than you've imagined it to be, try not to be angry. Try not to be impulsive and hot-headed, because Mars is still Mars. But when it's in the energy of Pisces, it's kind of like running in water. So you're getting all steamed up and hot and sweaty, and you're not going anywhere quickly, not at all, right? But in this combination with the sun here, what I think the square gives us an opportunity to do, you can tell Mercury retrograde's on the way. What it gives us an opportunity to do is to look back over, take action on some of the intuitive things, on some of the healing, on some of the transitioning, on some of the unconditional love, on the creativity. All of these are Pisces things, right? To take some action, Mars, on those Pisces things. And as it bumps up and squares against the sun says, I need to do these things to be vital. We need to make a move. We need to take action if we're going to be vital. We need to make some decisions, right? In the energy of the sun just beaming for us. So as we wrap up this week, I'm really interested to see what these shifts bring for you. And I'm also really interested to see what this Sun-Mars square brings to your attention. Where are you ready to take 911 level action, right? Like, you've got to move if you're going to stay vital. This is a really good way, I think, to end the week. Now, globally, this could be a little bit of a press. We've had a full moon that's going to affect this planet. Nobody is exempt from it. And then we do have a square to end the week. So I certainly certainly think that this is going to be an interesting week globally as well. Right now, the nation seems very, very raw, at least here in the United States. So certainly, we add some eclipse energies back to back to back all the way until July, and we're definitely going to see some shifting and some changing. So take care of yourself, stay safe, eat well, hydrate, rest to the very best of your ability, be very, very creative. That seems to be a wonderful outlet for people right now. And definitely give yourself some grace this week, okay? All right, you guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I hope to see you all at the Eat and Greets. We'll have Stephen Forrest this week and Maurice Fernandez. So it is going to be a rocking good time, all right? All right, you guys, I love you, and I'll see you next week. Bye, everyone.